I fold it into a triangle, and then another triangle, and then another triangle. Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. Merry Christmas! Feliz Navidad, Bon Noel, and Maligayang Pasko. We made it through Vlogmas. If you still have videos to watch, there's a playlist for Vlogmas, so go ahead and check that out. But thank you for hanging out with me, for getting some organizing inspiration, taking some room tours, taking some tours of my extended pantry, and doing some entertaining and setting up some tables. So in this video, my last one for Vlogmas, I'm just gonna show you how I've set up my Christmas table for breakfast. And I hope you enjoy. Let's get to it. So I'm in my dining room, and if you want a tour of it, just click the video in the icons above. I just have a slightly damp cloth, clean one with a little bit of dish soap. This is what I always use to wipe down this table. I got this table on Amazon, and it honestly, I think it took me 2 or 3 years to finally get the one that was decently what I wanted, with the color, the size, and definitely the price. So here in Arizona, it's always pretty dry. And so when I wipe down my table, I usually don't have to come back with a dry cloth to wipe it dry, because it pretty much dries quickly. So you can even see this is already drying. It's been less than a minute. Okay, so wiping down the table, and then I'm going to go get the placemats. And so what I'll do in this video is just talk, maybe explain what I'm doing, tell you where I got things. As always, I'll put everything in the description box below. And here are the placemats. I got them from Target. I actually saw that my son had them in his apartment. And if you want to take an apartment tour of this place in Boston, I'll also link that. And I just realized that there are still, that one part of the tag is still here. Okay, so this is for Christmas breakfast. And we won't need a lot of space, I'd say, for the for the food, because it's breakfast, you know. It's not like large entrees. A lot of the, so I'll just tell you the menu. I won't say a lot of the menu, but most of the menu is just stuff you can go ahead and put straight into the bowls. All right, so we're having oatmeal. My family loves oatmeal. They all love oatmeal. I'm the only one, like, I'll have it if I have to, or, you know, I don't mind eating it, but it's not something I order or grab at the buffet line or whatever. Okay, wow, so I still had all the tags there. So this is definitely, as you can see, a recent purchase. So I'm gonna lay out six. Although there's four of us, I just wanted to show you, or I want to show you, how I would lay this table out for six people. Right now it's a little bit cloudy outside, a little bit of wind, it's not blustery, but it's a, what's that called? Cloudy, some rain, and you know, it's kind of rare here in Phoenix, so I kind of like when that happens. I wish I didn't have to work necessarily today. I would just love to drink some hot cocoa and watch some movies, but I'll be doing that tonight. Okay, so we have the six plates, and then I've had this placemat, and it's from the brand Domini. I think I got it at TJ Maxx. So those are great places to look for any type of kitchenware or tableware. Ross, TJ Maxx, Home Goods, Marshalls, that whole, you know, discounted store type of stuff. Okay, so when I'm setting a table, you know, the first thing I'm gonna think about is kind of like the overall look or theme, vibe, color palette. however you want to say it, okay? So since I'm using my Mora ceramics, I know I kept mentioning this brand in my last video because I'm telling you guys, it's great, okay? So Mora ceramics, and what I love is that there's a little bit of a lip here in the dish. Okay, so I'm gonna put all those. Also guys, my son is arriving late tonight, so I'm excited about that. Get to spend 10 days with him here at home. The last time he was here was, I think, in July. We had him come here for his master's graduation party because he graduated in Philly. Oh, and I'm wearing the hoodie for his school. Okay, so he was here in July. Then prior to that, he was here in the previous December. And last December, we had decided to, we usually go out of town every December, every New Year's, because that's when we do our reflection and recap of the year, go over, you know, the positives and learn from the, whatever were the challenges of the year. And we just like to dream and plan for the next year. We've been doing that as a family since the kids were little. So it's our family tradition. But this year we decided we'll just stay home. I'm treating them to mani-pedis and to massages. So that we'll spend our money there versus at a hotel. Okay, so the next thing I'm doing is I'm taking these bowls. And I think they're called cereal bowls because they have, there's three types of bowls, or there's a few types of bowls that Mora Ceramics does. And listen, I'm not sponsored by Mora Ceramics. I'm just telling you, I'm just in love with these dishes. Maybe I should stop talking about it, but I do have a few more pieces. Okay, so I have this cereal bowl there because that's for the oatmeal. Okay, and of course the plate is going to be for bacon, eggs, hash browns, those are the typical things that we love to eat for breakfast. Now, one of my favorite things is breakfast, like a hot breakfast. And my kids know that when it's like Mother's Day, although my son is not here anymore for Mother's Day, but things like that or my birthday, they know just to cook me breakfast. I'm very happy with that. Okay, these are from the Philippines, but let me see if I can find them on Amazon. They're capiz, C-A-P-I-Z, and it's very popular material in the Philippines because it's beautiful. So these are coasters. Okay, so I have six of those. I actually have more. I do have placemats too, and I have seen them at TJ Maxx. Okay, or this type of material, sometimes placemats, bowls. All right, so I have that. Then I think I'm gonna put these bowls next. So these are the smaller bowls. You know, it could be, I think they call it ice cream bowls. Okay. And this is the vanilla white color. They have another color that's, I don't know what they call it. Like a variety. Okay. And those are pretty colors too. All right. So I know that, I mean, it would be nice to put the bowls up here, but I have a centerpiece going there. So I'm just gonna put here to the right, I mean to the left, kind of like almost, not at the straight line here, not at the parallel line, but just a little bit above it. And I'll just do it at the parallel because these don't fit. So just try to make everything as even as possible. And listen, if you were ever like into Downton Abbey and all that, that's a lot of work. So just do what you know you can do. And any effort that you make is gonna be amazing for whether it's for your family, for your guests, for yourself. You know, even if you're just having a dinner for two, a dinner for one. Okay, and then these Christmas candle holders, I love it, made of wire. And I just love the simplicity of it because that's what I'm going for with this theme. And then I found these also at home, and they were 50% off. So I was like, we'll take that. And then here's the second one. So again, the same thing, you just try to make them even, parallel, right? And versus like this, and that one is facing that way, so just make it the same as the other one. I usually like a centerpiece that's not too high, but I'm gonna go ahead and bring this one here because I was looking for a vase in general for my dining table. So I got this vase at home and it's greenish, and I like because it, you know, kind of plays off of my green velvet chairs, which I absolutely love. One of my favorite purchases. That's from Amazon, but you can get green velvet chairs in many places now. Okay, so I got this, and so there's three picks here. Okay, this one, kind of like a pine cone. And this one, which has some silver and glitter, which, you know, at first I wanted it to be like completely no glitter at all, but I think it worked out, right? There weren't a lot of choices when we went. This does have a little bit of glitter too. I kind of wanted it more rustic, but after I put it together, I was like, you know what? I do like the little bit of glitter here. And this one I have also in my front door. Instead of wreaths, I have like a basket that I could put different types of picks or flowers during the year to go with the season. And so that's what I use. Okay, so this is a little bit overhanging, and you know, the glitter will fall. All right, isn't that nice? Let me show a close up. All right, so this is what it looks like when you're kind of sitting from this area. And of course, when we eat, I'm gonna be taking that out. Here's what the table looks like so far. So can you feel the vibe? See the theme here? It's basically neutral with some green. Okay, I'm not very good at naming tablescapes, so not like a woodland warmth or cozy Christmas, you know, I'm not really good at that. So anyway, here are some linen napkins. I also got it at home, but you can get these anywhere, any big box store, Amazon. And so I'm gonna use the napkins and put these napkin rings on them, which is a Christmas tree. I love it. All right, let me just move this so you can see, but we're gonna do a very basic napkin fold. If you want the triangle, yeah, can you see? Okay, so the napkin comes like that, right, in a squarish, and obviously put the tag side down. You can always cut off the tag. Okay, so I fold it into a rectangle. I mean, I fold it into a triangle, and then another triangle, and then another triangle, okay? And so all you have to do is then I just fold it like that, put the napkin ring on, and then what you do after that is you just spread it. You know, just kind of spread the wings there, see? And when it's on there, look how pretty that drapes. Okay, I'll show you another fold. Move this again out of the way. Okay, so another thing you could do is like the fan, and you just, again, cover the tag, fold it into a rectangle, okay? And then you're going to fold it over, fold it under, fold it over, under, over, okay? So hold it down there in the middle, close it, get your napkin ring. Okay, so since this is showing the, I guess it's both sides, so you put the napkin ring through, okay, and then there's your fan. Oops, there. Okay, so that's that style. There's so many styles, you just go on YouTube and search for it. Thank you. folding the napkins and putting the napkin rings on took only 3 minutes for 6 of these. So if you just have basic napkins and focus on a napkin ring that you really like, you're gonna really dress up your table. Look how much nicer that looks with the napkins, with the napkin rings. Okay, this is what it looks like above when someone comes to the table and they go to sit down. All right, that looks good so far, right? But we're not done, we have to put the glasses. And so I have here my Bowden glasses. If you wanna watch my video of how I organized my drinkware cabinet, go ahead and watch that. So I'll put a link. This is Bowden, this is the 15 ounce, and like what I said in that video, what I like about this brand is the double wall. They're the original, but there are other kinds brands on Amazon or on the internet. I'm not sure how they are, but I stick with this brand because I know I love it. Okay, this one. Pull that a little closer. Don't want it dropping. Okay. All right. We got two more there. So that can be for like water, the way my family drinks orange juice. It could also be for orange juice, but I'm gonna bring out a cup for what I like to use for orange juice, especially if it's fresh squeezed. Unless you want a really big one. I mean, or you can interchange. You could put orange juice in the big cup and water in the smaller cup. So this is Bowden, and this is the 8 ounce. So you could put it here, okay? Just right in front. And I still need space for the coffee mug, so that's the challenge when you're setting up. Or let's see how that looks. I may just only put one glass versus two. How many more do I need? Two more. Okay. I mean, this would be a lot faster, right? If I'm not filming a video or talking, but you can see it doesn't take a lot of time to set this up and make it nice, right? Okay, so I can have this cup with the saucer, and I think I will just put it here. Yes, I think that's a good spot. I also have these big mugs, which I know would be good for hot chocolate. So I'm gonna fit everything on the table. So for now, we'll just use the small, they're called cappuccino cups. Same brand, and they also have an espresso size. Okay, so here with the cup. This is kind of interesting that these are right next to each other. You know, like here, I mean, it would be nice if I could put it up there, but I just want everything to be even. But again, it's your table setting. You do the way you think it would look nice for your guests and for you, what you like to do. Okay, got one there. Then we have two more. So this could be for coffee, obviously tea. My family drinks more tea than coffee. I would love coffee in the morning. And then I'm just gonna make sure that everything is placed correctly. Example, like the handle of the coffee mug, the cappuccino mug, is all facing the right, to the right. Okay, looks good. All right, so now pretend it's about time to eat, right? So we sit down, okay, and I'm not gonna have breakfast with this thing in the middle, no matter how pretty it is. It's great for like the impact when you first sit down, but then I'm going to move it out of the way, and it could still be a centerpiece. Once all the table is clear, it could still be a centerpiece for later. So it's not without its function, okay? And then I usually love like two tiers, three tiers, cake stands, something to lift up in the middle. So you can have something like this. Now it's your new centerpiece, but now it's gonna have pastries on it. And then the fruit will go here in the small bowl, the oatmeal, so they'll just go to the kitchen and grab their stuff. You can have carafes here and there for the orange juice and water. The Nespresso machine is here in my armoire. They can get the coffee or the tea from the tea organizer. And I have a hot water kettle in this armoire also. Okay. Then you can put stuff on here like these pears from Harry and David, a gift given to us, scones, and some muffins. Those are poppy seed muffins. Before I end this video, I just want to wish you a very happy holiday season to you, your family, your loved ones, your good friends, and a very Merry Christmas. This year has been a challenging one for me, to say the least. And if it's been challenging for you, please know that my heart is with you. My prayers are with you. Thank you so much for your support, the encouraging words, the guidance, and the grace that you've given me as I've navigated this channel. Make sure to subscribe and watch the videos, because I'm committed to you, to helping you stop living in chaos one organized space at a time. I have the videos planned for the first quarter, and trust me, it's going to be things that are going to really help you in really creating that sanctuary and that home that's a haven for you. I'll be posting in the community with different polls and strategies and tips in getting your space organized. Also, in any comments, please know that I try to get to all the comments. I have a bunch of comments I still have to reply to, but please know that I do look at all of them. You can ask me questions about organizing your space at any time. I can also be DM'd through Instagram. Although we're not talking about New Year's goals, I just want you to know that one of, not even just my goal, like what I said earlier, my commitment is to really helping you. I have a second wind. I know that I am called to really help others in creating that sanctuary in their home. And so I'm excited. I'm excited for the year coming up. I know that there will be more challenges with the things that I am responsible for and that I need to take care of, but that's life, right? But we're gonna do it together, and we're going to do it with success. Again, thank you so much. I can't express my gratitude for all of you who have followed me just recently or through the years. It blows my mind that you guys have been here for a long time. Blows my mind that I've been here for a long time, but let's get to it. And again, happy holidays and a happy new year to you.